That's magnificent. Thank you very much. One important thing that he didn't say, perhaps he couldn't say it because he was a bride's father, and I'm going to say it, and that is, what a beautiful looking bride Laurie looks. And of course, Gregor's not a bad looker either, is he? Troubles of being a minister is that you tend only to get to know one partner in a marriage. The daughter is a member of your congregation, perhaps, and the bride is a member of the congregation, and the groom turns up. And I think of this poor minister who didn't know who the groom was at all. And when he came to the altar of service, at that point when he asks them to repeat the vows, he suddenly realised he didn't know this fellow's name. And you know, you have to do this, but I Gregor, take you, or I, Stephen, take you, I'm a bell, whatever it is, you know. I Gregor, take you, Laurie. And he thought, I don't know what his name was, but he was a very clever minister, this, very clever indeed, and he thought a way around the problem. So he said in his big ministerial voice, "By what name have you come to this service?" Addressing the groom. Now, the trouble was that the groom was also very clever indeed, and he knew that that wasn't in the order of service. He thought a bit about this, and he says, "I have come in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ." Well, in a sense, you have come in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, but you've also come as plain, may I say, ordinary Gregor, but with all the charms that we've come to associate with you. That is with pleasure that I invite you now to address us. Let's give him a rousing welcome.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen.
Get that table out.
Ladies and gentlemen, I had a feeling my new father-in-law's might be a difficult act to follow, but you need to bear with me. I think we've been reading the same speech book, so half of it's just gone. But one of the quotes he did give me was from Shakespeare, who said, "Brevity is the soul of wit," and if this is the case, then I should have you rolling in the aisles. I'd like to start by endorsing most of what he's said, thanking you all for coming today. Thank you for the fantastic presents that you've all given us and we haven't replied to yet. We'll get around to it. I'd like to thank in particular those that have come from overseas, John Henderson from Canada, from Vancouver, and particularly Alan and Pip, who came in from Australia, from Sydney, the week before last, who've taken a mere 5 weeks holiday to be with us. For those of you that haven't met Pip yet, or Pip or Alan, they're sort of Pip's the Kylie Minogue and the Jason Donovan of Scotland. I think later on, if you meet Alan, there's a fair chance he might show you his didgeridoo. It certainly would be the first wedding he's let the family down. Photographs from the Watson wedding of his didgeridoo there. I'm particularly proud today to have, along with these people, my 90-year-old grandmother and her sister indeed. The two of them formed part of the Doon Trio back in the 1920s down in Girvan. I think Granny played the cello. It's especially nice to have them here today. I was speaking to Granny of the secrets of long life, and I think the reason she's lived so long is the fact she's been waiting for a Cameron wedding. I think if any of the rest of the family have anything to do from it, she should be hearing from the Queen. I'd like to hang on in there anyway. I'd like to turn to my new in-laws and thank them both very much, especially Laurie's mother, who's as we've already discussed, has put so much work and effort into today. Her father has worked so hard in order to pay for the day. I'd like to also thank them both for the amount of hard work they've put in the flat since we got that at the end. For humping furniture, organising vans, scraping walls, and a whole list of activities. I'd also like to include my mother in that. Well, firstly, thank her for all she has done, for looking after me for the last almost quarter of a century, for all the hard work she's put in. And I think we're both quite enjoyed it. I haven't really seen much sign of emotion, which has been a bit disappointing. I'm sure that will probably come with a few drinks. I was hoping maybe this morning she might get a bit emotional, but when the post arrived this morning, she actually won a premium bond for £50. Which seemed to more than compensate for the loss of her son. The number of people we have to thank, my wife and I. too numerous to mention. I'd also like to thank, I think it's Ian Poggenpole Foggy over there for his work. And is he over there? No?
Oh, is he?
He's been invited. To thank for the help he's put in organising our kitchen. There's still quite a few little jobs to be done in the flat, and the keys have been left at reception. We'll be back on the 9th of April. Lastly, I'd just like to turn to the bridesmaids, as that's what the toast is all about, and to thank the three of them who are looking so beautiful today. I'd like to thank Susie, who wasn't altogether delighted at the idea of wearing a dress and flowers in her hair. But you can be rest assured she's got her jeans and gutties on underneath. I'd like to turn to Anne, who's looking quite stunning today, looking incredibly brown. I think actually if Anne goes to the sunbed anymore as a date, she might start emitting radioactive. lastly, I'd just like to thank my sister Fiona. We've always been very close. I know it's particularly emotional for her today, and I only hope that she misses me as much as I'll miss her. I'd like to just sum up by thanking everybody very much for everything they've done. I can't go into everything, but just if you would be upstanding and join me in a toast to the bridesmaids, please. The bridesmaids.
Ladies and gentlemen, I call upon the best man to reply, and I don't know if it's widely known that the best man has come from Australia, and that surely deserves a very warm round of applause.
Beautiful.
beautiful bridesmaids as we have tonight. Gregor and Laurie have been going out for, I think it's 8 years now. Is it 8 years? Which is quite an achievement at the age of 24. But that didn't take away from the surprise that I got when I received a phone call from Gregor in July of last year in Australia. And that surprise I'm sure was felt by many people, not least of all Laurie. Apparently when Gregor finally proposed to Laurie, she got such a surprise she fell out of bed. Hoping to have a girl and complete the set. But no, unfortunately, it was born another boy, and that is the fine figure of manhood you see standing. Disappointed with respect to sex only, they decided to persevere. And on the 22nd of April, 1964, Mum gave birth to a lovely 7-pound baby boy. The midwife turned to Mum and said, "Congratulations, Mrs. Cameron, a 7-pound baby boy." Mum said, "Oh my God, another boy."
Oh, very good.
Sorry, the happy ending is the fourth child was born of the fair sex and is again seated beside us today. In fact, it's interesting to note the whole of the Cameron family represented on the top eight. Laurie, there was something I wanted to warn you about Gregor, particularly with respect to tonight, given tonight's circumstances. Suffice to say that if Gregor goes into the bathroom in the bedroom of the hotel tonight and locks himself in and asks you to knock on the door, don't be too surprised. This goes back to about 20 years ago. We used to go on a caravanning holiday with close friends of ours from Florida, now the Buchanan's. And we used to sit in this caravan, and Gregor used to go into the tiny wee cubicle bathroom that we had there. And to knock on the door signified to Gregor that was switching the radio on. And if he did that, he would break into a few bars, "Congratulations." And I thought, given tonight's circumstances, that may be a problem. Be warned. Finally, last Saturday night, as some of you may know, we had Gregor's stag night. And all I can report from that is that Gregor met a charming, young, lovely girl. Self-employed lady. His place of business is not a million miles away from his area. Anyway, she offered Gregor the experience of a lifetime. £10. And judging by the severe squint that she had, I think she'd been through a number of these experiences. And in fact, I was glad that we didn't have the wedding photographs in the park today, otherwise I thought you might see this wee squinting. Looking through the railings at her boy. Anyway, that's a bit enough for me. And it's just, I'd just like to take this opportunity to propose a toast to the parents, Les, Cuthbert Snow's wife, and my mother.
Avril.
Les and Avril Cuthbert Snow's wife, and my mother. So I'd like you to be upstanding and toast both sets of parents for bringing such fine people together.
Les and Avril.
Gentlemen, we're just to have a presentation now. Please give a warm applause as this is being given. Standard. Speaking as a professional minister, and being at several of these functions, I've seldom heard such consistently good speeches from all parties, and I think that has to be noted. I think also I ought to say that at the service itself, I'm not talking about that part of it. I'm talking about the vows I had seldom heard the vows said so clearly as we have heard from the bride and groom, with such clarity and conviction. And that, too, is such a promising start for their marriage together. And I have said how nice the bride looks, how handsome the groom looks, but more important than that, not just that they look good individually, they look good together as a team. They have that instinctive look about them as a marriage couple. They look as though they are meant for each other, and that's something that we're rejoicing over now. And so we have had a very happy day, a most enjoyable evening, a truly splendid meal. I think that has already been said, but it doesn't mind being repeated. And our thanks very much indeed to Mr. and Mrs. Cuthbertson for all the meal and all the organisation of the whole day. Two gentlemen at such an occasion as this, one was speaking to another, and one gentleman says, "You know, my wife, she's wonderful. She's just an angel." To which the other gentleman replied, "You're lucky. Mine is still alive." Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Schedule speech. I said, absolutely not. No, nobody else has got any chance. I want to say, shut up. I think it would be wrong of me to go, because I think it has set the scene today, right from the very beginning, that Reverend Donald, as I now know, started the Holy Week. A lovely service. He's helped things go fabulously well tonight. We're very grateful to him for cheering tonight and handling such a lovely service.
Here, here.
Thank you. Here, here.
Thank you.
I, Gregor, take you, Laurie, to be my wedded wife, and do in the presence of God, and before this congregation, promise to be a loving, faithful, and dutiful husband to you, until God shall separate us by death. I, Laurie, take you, Gregor, to be my wedded husband, and do in the presence of God, and before this congregation, promise to be a loving, faithful, and dutiful wife to you, until God shall separate us by death. Will you place the ring on this Bible? Gregor, will you take this ring and place it on your bride's finger? Forsaking all others, you now pledge that you will live only for each other in Christian marriage, as a seal to the promises you have made, and as a symbol of all that you will share in your lives together, this ring is given and received. Will you again take the right hand? By this sign, you now take each other to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until God shall separate you by death. Gregor Cameron and Laurie Cuthbertson have declared before God and before this congregation that they will live together in Christian marriage. They have made sacred promises to each other. They have symbolized these promises by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore declare them to be husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God hath joined, man must not separate. May it please thee. Let us pray. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace, now and forevermore. Amen.